Big horns, little horns. Yeah. Oh,
that's the fourth guy that's cracked up this week.
Now, what did you say?
I say that's the fourth man that had a nervous breakdown.
That's right. The G minor horn always gets them. What? I say, were the others all right? Just fair.
Put that thing down.
Well, I got to blow me on.
Doesn't this noise bother you?
No, it just goes in this ear and out of the other. Don't bother me a bit.
Haven't you got it fixed yet?
No, I haven't got it fixed yet. And furthermore, I'm not gonna fix it. Horns to the right of me. Horns to the left of me. Horns all over me. Fix it.
Come. Calm yourself, young man. Calm yourself.
Put that down.
There, your nerves are all jangled. I'd advise you to go home immediately and call your doctor.
That's just exactly what I'll do.
Yes.
Come, Stanley. Come on and let's go.
I'm too nervous.
best trying to do.
Hey, wreck my belly. Down. Look where you're...
What are you tiptoeing about? You don't have to be so quiet.
I'm not tiptoeing.
Well, what are you walking like that for?
Well, I've got a nail in my shoe.
Well, sit down and take it out.
Hold it a minute. Hello?
Hello? This is Dr. Finlayson.
Oh, just a minute. Must have been disunconnected. Hello?
Hello. This is Dr. Finlayson. Is this the home of Mr. Hardy?
Uh-huh. Uh-uh. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Uh-uh. Mm-hmm. Okay. Goodbye.
Who was it?
It was the doctor.
Well, what'd he say?
He said he'd be up here in about a quarter of an hour or 15 minutes. Quick as he can get here.
What have you got in this thing?
Nothing.
Well, what good is an ice bag without ice in it?
Well, we haven't any ice.
Well, put some cold water in it so I can put it on my head.
Well, I
didn't know.
I just called to see how Mr. Hardy is.
What's the big idea?
Shh.
Good morning, Doctor.
Good morning.
Well, I guess I'll be gone. Now, if there's anything I can do, let me know, won't you?
Thank you very much.
Come on, dear.
You want a banana, darling?
Yes, thank you.
Right here. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Come up and see me again sometime.
I will, thank you.
Now, let me see. Mm-hmm. Let me see your tongue.
Thank you.
Where can I get some water?
Right in the sink. Help yourself.
Nearly had me scared to death.
I will now test your lungs. Lie flat on your back and relax.
Yes, sir. What's that?
It's my own invention, the lung tester. 90 is normal. If you go above that, anything can happen. You hold this. Now, put this in your mouth.
Yes.
No. Just do exactly as I was doing.
Come on. How do you feel?
Seems to be the matter with me, Doctor.
Just as I suspected, a severe case of hornophobia.
Hornophobia?
Yes, you're allergic to horns. In fact, you're on the verge of hornomania. What you need is a complete rest, plenty of peace and quiet, and a strict diet of goat's milk.
Do goats have milk?
Not ghost. Goat! G-O-O-T! Goat! Now, take a nice hot bath and relax.
Where could I go to get some rest?
Well, you could take a nice ocean voyage. plenty of fresh sea air.
I'll go for the bath, all right, but you'll not get me out on any ocean.
Well, that's my advice. Take it or leave it. I don't give a continental. Remember, when you try to fool your doctor, you're only fooling yourself. And another thing. Oh, no!
Well, guess you'll have to take the doctor's advice. You heard what he said. If you don't, you're just fooling himself.
You can talk from now until doomsday, but you're not going to get me out on the ocean. Hornomania or no hornomania.
Just trying to help you. Say, you know what? Pardon me. I just thought of something. We don't have to go way out in the ocean to get sea air.
What do you mean?
Well, we can rent a boat, we can live on it, and we don't even have to leave the dock. Get all the sea air we want. Going on the ocean, silly.
Wouldn't that be fooling the doctor?
Well, you can fool the doctor some of the time, but you can't fool the doctor part of the time because you'll only be fooling yourself all of the time. What do you think?
That's exactly what we'll do.
Good. Now you can take a nice hot bath and relax, and the doctor won't have to give you a continental.
Right.
He didn't want to in the first place.
You've hit the nail right on the head. And while I'm taking my bath, you clean up this room.
Okay.
Never gonna fix the plumbing in this room.
But it has been fixed, Mr. Hardy.
Let me speak to the plumber.
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Hello, are you the man that fixed the plumbing in this room?
Yes, what's the matter with?
Well, it's all mixed up.
Well, I can't understand that. It looked all right to me.
You shouldn't be a plumber. You should be working crossword puzzles. Ha! That's telling them. Pardon me. If you're not too busy, would you mind fixing me a cup of coffee? Give him a large piece of my mind. Oh!
having any trouble?
Trouble? Well, the room is all topsy-turvy. Come on, Anne.
I will. Just have a look at mine.
All right.
I can't figure it out. I turned on my radio this morning, and look what happened. And that's not all. Just have a look at the radio.
Well, that's the last straw. I'll give that guy a piece of your mind, too.
Hello?
Hello, Mr. Laurel. Professor O'Brien is on his way up to give you your music lesson.
Well, I'm glad of that. You know, he's been expecting me. Mm-hmm. Well, call again sometime. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Ah, buongiorno, signore. When was the earthquake?
It wasn't an earthquake.
Funny, I didn't feel it. Well, let's begin practice with the music, huh? All right.
Where is the basement?
Downstairs.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Now, you listen to me, and I'll show you what I mean. All right? Good.
What'd you say?
Oh!
Where is the alley?
Out in the street.
Thanks very much. Just coming.
can I do for you?
I'm Mr. Hardy, and this is my friend, Mr. Laurel. Oh. We're the gentlemen that phoned you about the boat.
Oh, that's who we are. Well, come right down this way. It's already waiting for you.
All right, sir.
Let's go, kid.
Hell yes.
All right. Well, there she is. I can remember when she was the finest little craft that ever sailed the seven seas.
Come on, I'll show her to you.
She ain't much to look at now, but she'll answer your purpose as long as you don't take her away from the dock. If you need anything, you'll find me up to the store.
Okay, thanks very much. Goodbye.
Goodbye, mateys.
Goodbye. Chevy and Timbers. Say, what'll I do with Narcissus?
Tie it to the dock.
This is all right, isn't it? Well, we can rest. You know, your nerves are beginning to look better already.
What's the idea of bringing this along?
Oh, that. Well, you see, the professor said that if I didn't practice, I'd lose my lip. And I
yes,
don't...
and if you do practice, you'll lose your neck. Don't you realize the effect the sound of a horn has on me? It makes me fighting mad. In fact, it gives me the urge to kill. I could take a body and beat it in two and throw it dead. The very thought of it makes me tremble all over.
Well, I wouldn't get excited.
Who's excited?
Now, listen, now, be calm. You heard what the doctor said. You've got to have lots of peace and quiet, lots of goat's milk. And say, by the way, you haven't had any goat's milk, have you?
I'm glad you reminded.
I'm glad I did, too.
Get me some.
I will. It's a good thing for your nerves, and that's just what you need right now. Yes, sir. Won't take a minute. Pardon me. Say, how much milk do you want?
That'll be plenty.
That's okay.
By the way, you know how to milk a goat, don't you?
Sure, just the same as milking a cow. You hold the cup in this hand, you take the other hand by the tail, and you go like that. See? Except, of course, that's if you're left-handed, you hold the cup in the other hand. But I always hold it in this hand because...
Hold the tail in that hand. Such ignorance.
Here's a good one. This ought to send you to sleep. Listen. Old Mother Hubbard, she went to the cupboard to get a poor dog a bone. But when she came there, the cupboard was bare, and so the poor dog had none. Poor dog. She went to the baker's to buy him some bread. But when she came back, the poor dog was... Oh, gee. She took a clean dish to get him some tripe. But when she came back, he was smoking her pipe. How can a dead dog smoke?
What are you trying to do?
Shh. What's the matter?
Narcissus is in my bed.
Well, why don't you get her out?
Well, I tried to, but he doesn't pay any attention to me. So that's why I came and slept over here.
Well, what are we whispering about?
What?
What are we whispering about?
Well, I didn't want to wake you up.
Oh, thank you very much.
Good night.
Good night.
Get out of my bed and get in your own bed. You didn't want to wake me up.
What was that?
The goat just went out.
Well, I don't blame it. Now turn out that light and let me get some peace and quiet. Pick your feet up.
Sign of them?
Oh, take him in that way and the rest of you fellas come with me.
Thank you.
How'd you sleep, Ollie?
I slept like a log.
So did I.
You were right, Stanley. You can get just as much sea air tied here to the dock as you can out in the middle of the ocean.
Just exactly what I told you. And now, you're taking the doctor's orders at the same time.
That's right. Now, we'll go over to the store and have a nice breakfast.
That's swell. I'm hungry as a hunter.
Me too. Will you hurry up?
Well, I was only hanging me clothes up.
Excuse me, jitterbugs. Where are you heading for?
What do you mean, jitterbugs? And what business is it of yours where we're heading for? And furthermore, what do you mean trespassing on our private yacht? Now remember, two's company. Now you get off before I put you off.
Listen, Cream Puff. When I was a little boy, I was told to be seen and not heard.
Are you going to stand for that?
No, not. I should say not. I'll call an officer and have you arrested.
I wouldn't do that. Let's get a cop and he'll get a policeman and we'll fix him up. Coming on.
You go ashore and attend to that, Stanley, and I'll stay here and watch this ruffian.
That's a good idea. Look out. We'll give him a piece of...
Jitterbug, huh? Cream Puff. Fun. Well, you know, for two pence, I'd make you eat those words.
Hey, Ollie.
What?
Can I see you a minute?
What's that name?
Pardon us. On second thought, ignore it. Pardon us. What is it?
Look, somebody moved the dock. No use looking. I've looked everywhere. Can't see a thing.
Say, what's the big idea of Shanghai and us? If you don't get us back to that dock, there's going to be some trouble about this.
Is that so?
What do you mean, is that so? You don't realize who we are, do you?
No, who are you?
Well, I'm Mr. Hardy, and this is my friend, Mr. Laurel. What is it? Don't bother me now. And there's one more.
So you're Mr. Hardy and Mr. Laurel, are you?
Yes, sir.
Well, from now on, your name is Dizzy. And your name is Dopey. Any objections to that?
No, sir. If it wouldn't be asking too much, would you mind telling us your name?
Just call me Nick.
How do you do, Mr. Nick?
Gee, that's a pretty name.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like to have you meet Nick Jr. Now that we understand each other, let's cut out the formalities. What do you say?
It's okay with me.
Me too.
Fine. From now on, you're taking orders from me, understand?
Yes, sir.
Now, you two birds, get below and rustle me something to eat.
We can't get you anything to eat. We haven't got anything for ourselves, have we,
Ollie? No, sir.
Don't argue with me. Get below and rustle me up some grub.
Well, what's happening?
Get down there.
We're trying to tell you.
Get below. You wouldn't want Nick Jr. to get mad at you, would you?
No, sir. But you'll have to take pot luck.
Get going, Dizzy.
Yes,
and call me when it's ready.
Well, here's another nice bucket of suds you've gotten me into.
Well, I couldn't help it, Dizzy.
What do you mean you couldn't help? And don't call me Dizzy, Dopey. It was your idea to get us on this boat.
I'll never listen to another idea of yours as long as I live. And if I ever get out of this, I'll use my own judgment from then on.
Well, what are we going to do about something to eat, you?
Well, there's only one thing to do. Fake it.
What do you mean, fake it?
We'll serve him a synthetic meal.
Well, we haven't got any.
You don't understand. We'll substitute things. For instance, we'll use this string for spaghetti. And we'll use the soap for grated cheese and so on and so on.
Well, he can't eat that. It'll poison.
So what? If we don't get old Nick, Nick Jr. will get us.
You're right. Self-reservation is the last law of average.
Dopey, you amaze me.
Thank you, Dizzy. I get an idea.
Go ahead and fix the fire.
Say, can you use the sponge for anything?
Yeah, we can cut it up and use it for meatballs.
Good idea.
Hey, you get the table ready.
$1,000 reward for capture, dead or alive.
Good. Now, when he finishes eating this, the reward is just as good as in the palm of my hand.
What about me?
I'll take care of you.
I'll see what else I can fix. Say, do you think he'd like some bacon?
Yeah. Give him the waste.
Use for tomato sauce.
Look around and see if you can find anything that looks like it.
Say, how about this red paint?
Perfect. Heat it up.
What about bread?
We'll have to rustle him up some biscuits.
What will we use for that?
There's some talcum powder in my bag.
Fine, Mike. What's the trouble?
I rented Brittany Heat to a couple of landlubbers yesterday, and you know that tub ain't safe. So I told them not to take her out to sea, but they did, and I'm worried about them.
Well, we'll see what we can do for you.
Fine, fine, skipper.
Oh, speed ahead.
Gee, that looks good.
It sure does.
You never know it was sympathetic, would you? Wonderful.
What's that?
That's coffee.
What'd you make it out of?
I used a sack of your tobacco.
That'll fix him. Now, let's see.
Oh, Mr. Nick! Oh, Mr. Nick! Dinner is served!
It is, huh?
Yes, sir. You better eat it while it's good and hot.
Well, good and hot.
Looks good. Smells good. And it probably tastes good.
How about some nice hot coffee?
Later.
Okay.
You're going to like this because it's just like Mother used to make.
Oh, she never made any as good as this.
Well, if it's that good... You eat it.
I beg your pardon?
Eat it.
Well, I'm not a bit hungry, am I, Ollie?
No, and I'm on a diet.
You heard what I said. Eat.
No thanks.
Hey, take one. Take another. Won't you have one?
I never eat biscuits. You see, I owe... Well, maybe one. And maybe another one, too. Look, I got nothing to eat it with.
Here, I can wait.
Here you are, Dizzy. You're welcome. Like Mother used to make, eh, Dizzy? Only better. Eh, Dopey? Meatball, Dizzy.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
That's what I'd like to know.
Who's this guy?
That's the fellow that shanghaied us.
Shanghaied?
Yes, sir. Why, that's Nick Granger. The whole country's looking for him.
Put him in irons, boys.
Get up. Tow this cracker box back to port.
Do you two realize you got a nice reward coming to you for this?
What do you mean, we two? I'm going to get the reward.
Well, aren't you going to split it?
Certainly not. He's going to treat me right, aren't you, Ollie?
Why, certainly.
He'll take care of me, see?
Well, how in the world did you ever manage to subdue this fellow?
Well, I don't want to talk about myself.
Oh, go on, tell him, Ollie. Don't be a screwball all your life.
I don't want to
go ahead.
You tell him, Stanley.
All right, I'll tell him. You see, it happened like this. When those two guys came on board...
Two guys?
Oh, yeah, there was old Nick and there was Nick Jr. So, believe it or not, I got a swell idea. And this is what happened. Listen.
Horns! Horns!
Which cell is Nick Granger in?
Number 3.
Here's another nice mess you've gotten into.
What are you doing?